Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of this man and woman through holy matrimony. And you've been so close, so caring, the two actually accomplish an act that becomes one. The union of husband and wife, heart, body, and mind, is intended by God for their mutual joy. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, reverently and deliberately, and in accordance with the purpose for which it was instituted by God. Because you, Sarah, Mark, are about to enter this holy estate of matrimony, which is to be held in honor by all, it is important for you to hear what the Word of God teaches concerning this estate and understand God's blessed purpose for your life. In the earliest chapters of the Bible, we hear that at the beginning of time, God himself created and ordained marriage, not as a burden or prison, but for a blessing. He wanted to establish a mutually beneficial union where two people are not independent of, but dependent on each other for strength, comfort, and support in good times and bad. Where two give themselves exclusively to one another and make a lifelong commitment to remain with each other, for better or worse, richer or poorer, in sickness or in health until death. It's that type of commitment that is epitomized by the words of Ruth in the first chapter beginning with the 16th verse. Don't urge me to leave you or to turn back from you. Where you go, I will go. And where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severely, if anything but death separates you from me. God's word also points out to us that the one thing that enables a man and woman to give themselves away to each other is love. A love that is not only expressed in words, but in everyday actions. Paul clearly describes the daily love that marriage is based upon when he wrote this to the Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Basically, it is a self-sacrifice. After God's love for us, it moved him to send his one and only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. John reminds us of this in his first epistle, and this is going to form the basis for your wedding meditation this morning. John writes this: Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God. Everyone who believes in Jesus, Love shows itself in truth and faithfulness, in thoughtfulness and understanding, in patience and kindness. Marriage furnishes a unique opportunity to put this love into practice. You have come here to be united in marriage, which consists in your mutual consent, sincerely and freely given. You are now invited to declare this intent in the presence of God and these witnesses. Mark Nixon, will you take Sarah Eisner to be your wife? Will you be guided by the counsel and direction God has given in His Word and love your wife as Christ loved the church? Will you be faithful to her, cherish her, support her, and help her in sickness and in health as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. Will you take Mark Gibson to be your husband? Will you be guided by the counsel and direction God has given in His Word and love your husband as Christ loved the church? Will you be faithful to him, cherish him, support him, and help him in sickness and in health as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Join your hands as you make your promises to each other. And Mark, repeat after me. I, Mark Gibson. In the presence of God and these witnesses.
In the presence of God and these witnesses.
Take you, Sarah Eisner.
Take you, Sarah Eisner.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Sarah, the repeat after me. I, Sarah Eisner.
I, Sarah Eisner.
In the presence of God and these witnesses.
Take you, Mark Gibson,
to be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you as long as we both shall live. Exchange rings is a symbol of a lifelong commitment and abiding love which you as husband and wife have promised each other. May I have your rings. By their promises, Mark and Sarah have bound themselves together in marriage before God and these witnesses. Therefore,